Hey guys, welcome to July 4th week. I'm peeling everywhere. So excuse me if I pick at my face. I am peeling from the sun because we finally have sun in here. Oh my gosh, finally. So I have something for you. Pop in, say hi, see, can you? Oh my gosh, you guys are already here. Awesome. Okay, hold on 1 second. Keep yourself company for 30 seconds. I'm back.
Whoa.
Nice clean floors, roll right by. So, hey guys, can you all hear me? I see all of you. I can't believe you guys aren't on vacation. I thought, you know what? It's going to be the quietest day today for the launch of the Linda Tunick Sew Along because I thought we'd all be on vacation, but maybe you are on vacation and that's why you're here. So, I hope you guys have good things planned for this week. I'm actually working, getting ready for It's So Easy TV. So, this might be our only live show this week. If I can roll in tomorrow, I will. But today is the launch of the Linda Tunick Sew Along. So let's get rolling. Jan says, I can hear you, but you're out of focus. Okay, well, how about anybody else? Mary's on vacation. Hi, Esther. Great to see you. Jan? Okay, so you guys, let me know if you can hear me and I'm all good. Hi, Marianne. How do you like my Texas necklace? Thank you, Jenny. I hang it on my computer screen here, and today I was like, wait, I need a necklace. Perfect. Oh, awesome, Trudy. You got your sister coming in, Marsha. Very fun. All right, so it looks like I'm clear. You can all hear me, so if you can't for some reason, refresh your screen. But remember, when it comes to live shows, depending on your internet, my internet, whatever, you never know what might happen. If we go dead, I usually come back. But if you can't get the reception and everybody else's, remember to hit save and share it to your page. And that way you can go back and watch it later. After it's not live, it will usually play just fine. So for all you newbies to this crazy Facebook Live stuff, you just never know what's going to happen. So, hey, Karen, great to see you. Barb, we got a bunch of new people in here too. Wonderful. All right. So we are going to talk about the Linda Tunick. So many of you, I'm recognizing a ton of you from the Fashion Sewing Club. So this won't be quite like Groundhog Day because we're going to still do live Q&A and this is open to everyone. You don't have to be part of the Fashion Sewing Club, but the Fashion Sewing Club people got a special 2 days last week of live Q&A getting ready for the Linda Tunick where we covered a lot of this stuff. So all of you that joined or you're taking the free trial, make sure to go into the club and watch those videos because we had a great one last Thursday about altering the sleeves and different fitting things. So, all right, what about this pattern? I'm so excited. I actually just pulled this out of the dryer. It's kind of wrinkled, but not too bad. I love it. It's that rayon challis. Rayon challis. I'm going to put this up on the screen. Technical difficulty. Sandra wants to know if I plan to go live. Does that mean she will not be on or past or she's on or Sandra? I'm on. So maybe refresh your page. I don't know if anybody can send her a message. Sandra, we're here. Oh, hey, Marcy. All right, you guys. So I am blown away by how many people are going to be sewing this pattern. And I want to show a couple of cute renditions for you guys to get inspired. If you're not in the Angela Wolf patterns group, it's free. All you have to do is answer a question to get in so we know that you're real and you really want to. So we let you in. And there's a ton of great videos in there. Or not great videos, great outfits. Okay, so let me just turn that off. All right, so to get started with your pattern, you're going to need, for those of you that have already started or haven't touched a thing, you need the pattern. It either comes in Mrs. size or women's sizing. Some people needed both sizing, no problem. All you have to do is message me. That's about all that you need there. But I want to point out a couple things in the booklet. All right. Hey, guys, thanks. Hi, Birdie. I see you guys are saying you guys can see from the group. Thank you for sending Sandra a message. All right, so inside is all the stuff that you're going to need to pick your size. This is really important, and I really want to spend a few minutes on this without overkill, but explaining that this top has a lot of ease. What is ease? This extra room. I could probably go down a couple sizes, so it really just depends how loose you want your garment to go. So I'm going to just take this down. All right. So on page 5 of your booklet, it tells you the misses sizes and the plus sizes. So I've mentioned this a million times. I have other videos to explain this, but for all of you newbies, Melody. Oh gosh, you guys are hilarious. Melody says she had to kick the dude off so she could log in. Tell him hi. I hope you guys have a good 4th. And, oh, hey, Julie. Julie's in here, my sister. So, Julie, you're going to the beach. I'm a little jealous about that. Although we have beautiful weather, I'm just not going to be able to enjoy it much because of this. Getting ready for it so easy. All right, so again, on this page, squirrel, page 5. You have general measurements and you have exact measurements. General and exact. Now, I know you're not going to see this on the screen, but when you look at your pattern or if you have the downloadable, you'll see this on there as well. So this is really important. The general measurements are everything of, that's the sloper that I use. So that does not, I mean, that's just a general. The exact measurements is the exact measurement of the garment. So on here, and this writing is so tiny, I have to put my glasses onto this. So what I want you to do when you're choosing your size, now I had to laugh because I was wearing workout clothes earlier. I changed my shirt and then I realized we're going live and I thought, you know, if I stand up, it's going to be like one of those commercials where you stand up in your boxer shorts. Now it wasn't that bad, but I did throw on some jean shorts. But yeah, I know. No, I did not make them. Okay, so let me just roll down. I can see you guys are so funny. I can see and hear you. Wonderful. Okay, so I brought in this lovely lady here. You might recognize this dress form from our wonderful friend, Joe. All right, so what you need to do, and I hope you can see this, you need to check your bust, and that's your full bust measurement, not the under and not the upper. Full bust measurement for what I'm talking about here. And you need your waist measurement and your hips. So when you take your measurement, now you're probably going to have to do it yourself. So if you have to do it yourself, I'm just going to show you how I do it. Stand up and you make sure in the back that this is straight, parallel to the floor. Not showing you the measurement there, but you hold your thumb there, give yourself a little bit of ease, and that's your full measurement, whatever that is, right? Okay, I know, I can see you laughing. Some things you got to keep to yourself, right? So this is what I'm talking about. This needs to go straight across your back. Don't have it sideways. Don't have it this way. It needs to be like this. And then in the front, checking that that's straight in the back, this is your front measurement. Now, this is going to be very important, especially for some other patterns I have coming out. These measurements you're going to need. So if you don't change sizes, write these down and just save it. Now, yes, you do have your lingerie on with this. So if you wear whatever kind of lingerie, that's how you want these measurements. Otherwise, it's not going to make a difference. I mean, you might have enhancers going on or anything like that, if you know what I mean. I'm trying to clean this up for all the kids that are watching this. So whatever lingerie you're going to wear under this shirt, wear that here. Okay. I can see you guys saying, oh my gosh, Gail has a tornado warning. So it's not me. It might be the weather. And Shirley is in. And I saw someone else. Terry, you don't have to share everything. I agree. Okay. So here is our little dress form. So this is what I was showing you. It's full. Put your finger right through here, get your measurement, and then you have to go to the waist. Again, making sure that your waist measurement is straight across the front and back. I usually put my finger under here to get the exact measurement. And then you go down to the fullest part of your hip. Now, your full hip might be higher or lower than mine. I'm using the dress form usually. Let's see, I think that's about, I want to say 8 inches. Yeah, usually about 8 inches on the dress form. But I don't know what it is on you. It might be different. So I'm talking about the fullest part of your hip. You guys ever heard that story about the fashion show I had where all the girls gave me measurements for their hips? And I walked in the room and I knew for sure that this was not going to work. This is years ago. And none of them are on here. So don't be offended if you've modeled for me recently. This is not you. So anyways, they gave me measurements and they measured way down here at the bottom of their legs, not including their hip or their tush, if you know what I'm talking about. That didn't work out so well when you're trying to model jeans. So again, it's the fullest part of your hip, right here, the fullest part. If for some reason you have a full tummy or anything like that, you might want to get the high stomach area. That's what I call it, like the tummy area. Or high hip, call it whatever you want, something like that. The other measurement you're going to need is, and I'll talk loud because I got the mic way over here. Hi, Fran, great to see you. By the way, thanks for joining the Fashion Sewing Club today. I sent you an email earlier. So here's your back neckline. You want to measure down to where your waist is, and you want to measure how long you want that top. So the back of the top is longer than the front, and it has a side slit. See what I got going? Oh, mine's tucked in. Nothing like messing that up, right? So you need to measure how long do you want this top to go? Do you want it to go right below your tush? You want it to go longer? I'm going to show you a couple photos here when we're finished because we're keeping this to a short show. So there's not a ton of show and tell, but Amy did the cutest shirt dress, which I knew you would, Amy. You always have the funnest dresses. Oh my gosh. So how long do you want it? Do you want it to go way down here? You need to measure that so you know. Now, there was another funny thing in the group. and she made her shirt into a dress, a kind of a dress, and forgot that the sides have slits. So she gave us a cute giggle on that one. So those are the measurements that you need. All right. I'm reading some of your things. Your friend Vanessa has a tape measure that you can measure with a snap. Awesome. Oh, I love Vanessa. I'll have to find out what she has. Maybe I can get a link for you guys. She's wonderful. Jill, yes, everybody's outfits in there are awesome. And you're welcome, Fran. So again, on page 5, what I'm going to do is take those measurements that I just took and relay them to here. So what I usually do is I start with the exact size to give myself a base. What size am I? I'm somewhere between the 4 and the 6. Or maybe you're somewhere between the 14 and the 16. Whatever your measurements are. Maybe you're a 28W or a 30W. Whatever it is, go to your exact measurements to get a broad range. And know that I use those measurements for a sloper. But that doesn't mean that's the top that you have to cut. So for me, I cut out the size 6 for this top, and it's pretty big, but I wanted it that way. Now I also want to make another one that isn't quite this big. I'll get to this in a second for the neckline. So the next one I'm going to cut out, I might actually go down to a 4 just because I want it to be a little bit tighter. So what you'll know, oh, sorry guys. Thanks, Karina. What would I do without you guys? What would I do? Mm-hmm. Got it. All right. When you're small, medium, and large. I know, it gets a little tricky. So I will go through here and I'll say, okay, this size, these are the exact measurements. I have the exact bust, the exact hips, waist, and back length. So the back length on here is from your back neck to where the bottom of the top is going to go without any alterations. So what do you do if your measurement's all over the map? That means that you're beautiful, by the way. Whoever made up all these crazy measurements anyways? But this is what you have to keep in mind. This shirt has a lot of ease in the bust area. I've probably got, oh gosh, a good 5 inches in the bust area. The hip is a little bit tighter. There's still a lot of ease, all right? There's still a lot of ease, but not as much as up here. Okay, look at this little lady here. Julie's on here because she's waiting to see if I sent this to her, her late birthday present. I needed a Julie just for the beginning of the Linda tunic. Yes, my sister's getting this top. So there's quite a bit of ease through here and less through the hip area. So compare your measurements to the exact measurements on the pattern. You don't want it to be super huge out here because then this is going to be monstrously huge. So look at the measurements and try to give yourself about a four inch ease through this area here. Through the hip area, you need at least a 2 inch ease or you can't get it over your head. Okay, so can you remember that? Ease means that's the extra amount of fabric greater than you are. So if you're, say, a 36 here and you decide to go with the size 40 bust, you're that would mean you have 4 inches of ease. You understand that? Oh, Debbie said she found the ease to be perfect. And I do see, Julie, you are hilarious. You do need a lot of ease in the bust. And yes, I figured that is why you're watching on your vacation, to see if I still have your top. I have to get rolling. All right, so do you have any questions about ease? Because that's really important, picking the right size. Do you really need to go through the trouble of cutting a whole muslin for this one? It's totally up to you. If you're really insecure and you bought fabric that's somewhat expensive, go ahead and get a $2 muslin or a $3 muslin fabric and then use that to cut out at first. First, there's a lot of people in the groups that are willing to help. All right. So the Fashion Sewing Club group, I help with fitting. In the Angela Wolf Patterns group, I always pop in and say hi, but we don't do a lot of fitting there. But a lot of the group members help. So you have two options there. One free, one almost free, but not free. Okay, so that's one thing. The whole point of doing this top as a sew along is to encourage each other, help each other. If you get stuck, go pop in the group and ask a question. If I don't answer, somebody else does. Trust me, there are some really good seamstresses in there if you've seen their clothes. So that's the thing about ease. So what about the neckline? I'm watching a Trudy says she made the top perfectly without any adjustments. Trudy, I'm going to show off your top if you don't mind, because it was really, really cute. All right, what about the neckline? Here's a big one. If you're going to cut out the neckline, it goes from measure from your neck down to how low you want this slit to go. How low do you go? Don't get any bad ideas about that. All right. It just, never mind. It's a joke, inside joke. Shouldn't do that. But probably all of you have heard the joke, so I'm just going to leave it there. So this is the front neckline. Do you want this to be this far down? All right. And if you don't, it's very, very, very simple to change that. And I'm going to just open something here to show you. Hopefully I can share my screen without everything going on. Hi, Denise. I see you're on here. Hey, Denise, I was wondering, do you mind if I show your top as well? Because it was super cute. Usually I try to ask you guys before I bring it live, but most of you don't care. So, and usually you don't, but I just thought I'd ask. Lynn says she bought 6 yards, one to make mistakes and the other amount to make an original and then pattern hacks. Great idea. And you know, Lynn, what you said there, this sounds kind of funny, but if you find a fabric you like that's not very expensive. Have you seen the rayon chalice from Vogue Fabrics? So let me bring that up. I'm bringing a couple things up here for you guys as resources. And don't forget, you don't have to remember all of this, or if you're watching this later, just save it to your page, your own Facebook page, and that way you can check this video later. So let me just show you this. All of the colors, okay? Let's see. Let me share this on here. Make sure I share the right page on here. Here we go. The internet's acting a little bit weird today, so we hope that there's no buzzing or anything crazy like that. Oh, Sandy's saying she loves the two-tone tunics and the suggestion to make it in cheaper fabric first. Yes, and you know who's been doing a couple of those tunics with the two? Oh, and I agree, Karen. A tunic underneath is great. Janet has those two tones. I love that. Okay, so here's Vogue Fabrics. And what I want to point out here is not this black piece, but it's rayon chalice solid fabric. $4.99 a yard. That is very inexpensive for, this is what I'm wearing here. Now, if you're in the Fashion Sewing Club, don't forget, they have a discount code in there. I'm sorry that I don't have a discount for everybody, but it's just a perk for being in the club. The whole point of the club is you save enough that the club is free, but that's the point. But here is black. I have a ton of colors in here. Even if you don't have a coupon, though, this fabric is not very expensive. This is why I didn't purchase it, because by the time I have to add on my cost, you might as well just go to Vogue Fabrics, which I love that store anyways. Here's another color. It's 100% rayon, 56, 57 inches wide. Here's a bunch of other colors they have. Here's the dark, the navy. You've seen me wear the navy. I think that one's in my laundry right now. And here's another color. Let me just show you. Here's your word for the day. There is a plethora of colors here. All right. Look at this. This is another jade color. I'm pointing the wrong direction. You're going to think I'm pointing. Let me move this to the over here to the screen. See, I'm pointing the right way. Wait, you're looking at me. Hold on. There you go. Did you like that picture of Wynn and I? I snapped that in the car one day with all the luggage behind us. You know how Wynn got his name CEO? Carry everything out. All right, so I'm reading some of your comments real quick while I'm looking at this fabric. Anne, how would you do a round back adjustment with the yoke? So Anne, what I would do is adjust, you're talking about upper round back. I would adjust the yoke and you're going to, let's see, because there's a shoulder line on the yoke. Now the yoke goes to here and back here. So you'll have to figure out where the shoulder line is. And I'm pretty sure I have a notch on there. So you would treat it just like the shoulder line. Even if you had to cut the shoulder line apart, do your adjustment like you would normally do on your pattern, and then tape the shoulders back together. I don't have anything here right now to do an upper back, but let me, I'm going to write this down on my blog post for you, Anball. Round back adjustment. And I'm assuming you're talking about your upper back. If you're not, let me know. So that one, I'm putting this note up here to remind myself to do a blog post. It's easier for me to do the sketches and then post them as a blog. Mary Smith says her fabric was on the reduced shelf at Joann's, cost her $3.54 total. Okay, that's awesome. Linda, great to see you. So Lynn, bringing back your quick comment about having extra fabric. First of all, that is a great idea, because if you make a mistake or anything like that and you're thinking, okay, what do I do with this? Or maybe you really like the fabric and you would want to do a short sleeve version. If you like the fabric, order a little bit more of it, exactly what you've said. So I have enough of this fabric to make about 4 of these tops, but that's because I needed this for It So Easy. Okay. So, but I want to open up to show you how to do the neckline before I get sidetracked. Squirrel. I know that commercial cracks me up every single time. Squirrels in the attic again. Okay, I think this is it. Let's see. The Linda pattern. And again, for those of you in Fashion Sewing Club, if you want to find any fitting or pattern hacks, please go back and watch that video, because we spent almost 2 hours in there the other day. Way longer than I planned, but it worked out well. Okay, so here is, I'm just going to open the screen for you guys to see this. This is just a generic of the pattern, all right? Okay. And let's share this desktop. Now bring this one down. I think this will work. So I'm going to make myself small here. All right. Can you guys see this okay? And you can hear me okay? I'm trying to make this bigger for you. How about the other bigger? Hey, Michelle, great to see you. She can't stay. She's taking her daughter out for her 31st birthday. Congratulations. And yes, happy 4th. Janet made her tops from Vogue Fabrics, and they were super cute. I agree, Susan, super big bargain. And I think they had some sales going on this weekend, too. So, Joey, it's okay. Don't worry. It doesn't matter where your measurements are. If you really get stuck, what I've been trying to do is have you guys email me, but my Outlook account is not, for some reason, a lot of when I return your email, it's not going through. And I don't know if it's because you don't have me saved or something. So I've had to try to refigure out people's email addresses. Probably the fastest way, why don't in the group, I'll just post after this live here in the Angela Wolf Patterns group, which many of you joined. If you didn't, this is it. Just so you know, you don't get confused, which one? Angela Wolf Patterns group. Just look that up. There's a couple outfits on the front cover. I'll put a post, you need help choosing a size. And that way it's all on one page and I don't have to worry about these emails not going through, because that's gonna make me crazy. And plus you think I'm not replying. Judy, I've not used them, Sawyerbrook Fabrics. If anybody has an input, that's fine. I have my sources that I use and that doesn't happen to be one of them. So I really don't have a feedback on that for you. April, off to work. April from Australia. Bye, April, off to work. Glenda says, hi, Wynn. Okay, so before I get to the sizing, Mary Smith says, do you wash and put this in the dryer all the time before cutting out and wearing? Yes, 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 yes. Double yes. I wash and dry all of my fabrics before I cut it. In fact, I went shopping yesterday to get a few pieces of lining for the jackets I'm working on for It's So Easy next week for taping. And when I purchased the lining, now I'm not going to wash and dry the lining because it's polyester. The wool has already been pre-treated, so I'm going to steam press that. But for something like this, a rayon chalice, I throw it in the wash, I throw it in the dryer, press it, and then cut it out. It's just wise, and rayon does shrink a little bit in the length. Plus, if your fabric ends up being some weird piece that the dye goes crazy on it, or it wrinkles too much, or it comes out of the dryer and you're like, oh, this is awful, which that has happened. And I believe that's exactly what I said, maybe plus a few other words. But that was because I already made the top. And then I washed and dried it, thinking that, oh, it's a polyester blend, it's not going to shrink. Well, it was not a good piece of fabric. That hasn't happened a lot, but a few times. So would you rather know before you cut the top out? I can see you guys saying, everyone's saying the video is fine. Whoever's not, try a different browser. You guys are so good at helping each other. Thanks, Jan. All right. Glenda says, if the yoke goes past the shoulder line, can you cut the yoke a smaller size and the rest of your size? You mean out here? It's designed to go a little bit over your shoulder, Glenda. That's kind of the sloppy, it's kind of a sloppier style, not sloppy, but a blouse style. So it doesn't go exactly to your shoulder. You can cut it that way if you want to, but all right, let me just see if I can bring that smaller for a second. All right. So on mine, it goes past my shoulder, probably, I don't know, maybe an inch and a half. So if you want it higher on your shoulder, you can do that. And there's a few different ways you can do that. You can just cut up your shoulder through here, and then you're going to have to alter your sleeve a little bit. Because when you do that, depending on if you're going to keep all the width down here, you have a lot of things to consider. If you cut the shoulder up, it's going to affect the size of your sleeve. So you might have to make just a little bit longer, I should say, higher sleeve cap, which I'll show you here in just a second how to do that. But then you also have to consider, are you taking it through here? So that's totally up to you. Mistakes. Four trash collars. Glenda, what? I better do another video on trash collars. Now, if you haven't seen all the It's So Easy episodes, that shows the collar. But the collar takes a little bit, but it's not that difficult. So, but I will come and maybe see if I can help you in there. Oh, hey, full attention now. USA won the game over England. Woo! I did tell you guys I was the only girl on the guys' soccer team for all of high school. They didn't have a girls' team. What the heck? I played all the time up in Illinois. I moved to North Carolina. No girls' team. So I don't know if the guys hated me or loved me, but I was the only one on the high school team for my lifetime of soccer, which was from the time I was 5 years old until my senior year in high school. I was going to play in college, and they didn't have any cool, they didn't make it so cool looking like they do now. I moved on. Where past the shoulder bone does the yoke end? Connie wants to know. Mine is about an inch and a half. I don't remember the exact measurement on the sloper, but it was about an inch to 1 to 2 inches. It's supposed to be a little bit sloppy. Another thing you can do is take it in the center back and center front just to take it up a little bit if you want to take the whole shirt up. Susan says the only thing she doesn't use is silk charmeuse. Well, you want to see something? I'll show it to you right before we leave because we're past our 30 minutes, but I still have more to show you. All right, so let me just show you this top real quick. All right, you on here? Here we go. Here is your pattern piece. Now, right now I just have one bar along here. You can see these notches. These are the different sizes. So obviously this coordinates with the largest size and this one's with the smallest. Right now, this measurement would be, that's where you're going to put this part. Okay, that's your yoke. You can see me down here in the little corner, all right? What if you want that higher? Well, this is very simple. You're going to take this entire piece right here and just redraw it as high as you need it to go. That's it. It still stays the same width on whatever size, but you're moving this whole section up. And that means your opening would now be somewhere in this area. So if you measure your neckline, you're on the biggest size. Let's say you measure from here and you want your opening to go right here. Then you're going to take this entire thing and move it up to here. Just make sure that it's open enough that you can get it over your head. Okay? And then the sleeve, I'm going to take one thing about the sleeve here. Let me just open one more. Okay, you got it? Here's the sleeve. For those of you that want to make it a short sleeve, all you have to do is draw a line, figure out from your shoulder down to where you want your sleeve to go, and give yourself a notch wherever you want that, and you're going to make a line parallel across this entire section, just like this. See if I can make that a little darker. And add yourself a seam allowance, which again, your seam allowance is going to look something like, this is very broad, but it's going to look something like this. Because when you turn this up, it needs to fit back into place. So your pattern then would go down, out, across, there, and there. And there you go. This would be your fold line, and this is your hem allowance. Notice that once I folded this up, it would probably fit pretty right into here. So I'm just drawing this very freely, very fast. And so just so you know, it's not exact science. All right, so when it comes to cutting, a couple more things, and then I'm gonna let you guys go because it's 5 o'clock and we have July 4th going on. So, and I've got two nephews waiting for me. Uncle Buck is babysitting right now. Oh boy, that's Wynn's nickname from them. They said he's so much fun, he's Uncle Buck. So when you put your interfacing on the back of this sheet, the back of your front, this is to stabilize your neckline area. So I had a piece right here. This is just fusing it. It's very light, see-through, has a little bit of stretch, if I can get it the right way, just a little bit of stretch. You're going to cut this out, lay it with the wrong side down, make sure there's no wrinkles on here at all, give it a good pressing, and hold it in place with a little bit of steam. That'll get that to stick really well. So then when you wash it, it doesn't come up. That's going to go on your neckline and then your collar and your plackets. So when you cut your garment out, if you're really trying to save fabric and you're cutting one piece this way and one piece this way, just know that sometimes there's a sheen on the fabric, even if there's not a nap. So a nap, think of corduroy, where you just rub it and the nap's going one direction. I cut all of my pieces out going this way. That's the yardage that I gave you also for your yardage. If for some reason, now there are other ways to cut this besides what I gave you. So if you say, you know what, I could cut the center front here, lay out my fabric and have one sleeve here, then the back and flip the sleeve over and cut that out to save fabric, go for it. I just didn't want to take 5 pages up in the booklet for how to cut out your fabric. So I cut all of my pieces going, let's see. If I can find the page. There you go. Can you see that? I cut all my pieces going the same direction. So I gave you some tips in there how to do that. As you go through the directions for your top. Now the sew along, the entire sew along is going to last for over a month. So don't feel like you have to be rushed. Many of you have already made the top. So I just want to bring a couple of these up. And I also wanted to point out that on the blog, make sure I got the right thing coming up here. See if I can bring this back up for you guys. I can never get this done in an hour, can I? We just have way too much fun. Everyone's saying your fabric is washed. Yes, yes, yes. And don't worry, I'll be popping in the group every day. So Melody says fishing took over from soccer. Yeah, I think that probably is something like what that happens. Charlene, I see you have a question about the neckline. Your collar rubs on your jawline. Is there a way to make it smaller? Just make it shorter. Make it shorter. So if your collar is cut this wide, just cut it shorter. And cut your collar. Cut it from the top, though. The bottom part is the part that matches your collar. So cut this part right here, shorter. You could also attach it lower onto your neckline, too, if you know how to do that. Hey, Jen, you just popped in. See what I was wearing, in case you missed that earlier. All right, so here is the blog. If you go to fashionsewingwithangelawolf.com, if you're in the group, it's already there. I've posted it everywhere. I sent a newsletter out this morning. So if you didn't get a newsletter, message me or sign up for the newsletter. Go to Fashion Sewing with Angela Wolf or angelawolf.com and sign up, because I'm going to be sending out newsletters so you don't have to try to figure out where on the map we are that day. But on here, if you click on the Linda Tunic Sew Along, some of you said you didn't get a chance to order your pattern and begged me to extend the sale. Okay, July 14th. Then we're done. July 14th is the sale for the Linda Tunic pattern. And then it goes back to other sales. So that's one thing. Here are all the videos for you to watch so you can see all the It's So Easy episodes right from here. You don't have to go anyplace else. And there's a link to the Angela Facebook page. Every single day, July 8th is our next live Q&A. Now, what happens for that one? That one is on a different platform. It's the platform that we use for the Fashion Sewing Club for our live Q&As, but I'm giving you guys all an opportunity to pop in for the sew along. So this is everybody. So you can leave questions in advance. I left a link right here for you to follow, and it's a live Q&A, and click right here to save your spot. Okay. So when you click right there, I'm probably already logged in, so it might look different for me. It shows I'm already logged in. Suzanne's already in here. Marcy is in here. Clovis is in here. And Judy's already in there. It says it's starting in 5 days, 20 minutes. If you've never been here before to this platform, you'll have to use your email and password. So remember what email you use and try to use the same password. If you're in the Fashion Sewing Club, use your same password so you don't have to keep remembering. But this is open to anybody. Totally free, but you can join us. And if you click down here, you can ask a question in advance. Ask a question or suggest a topic. And then what will happen during our live, I will go through and pick the most important questions, because the live will only be 1 hour. All right, so you got that going for you. And then one more thing on the Fashion Sewing Club. In the newsletter today, there was a big discount for our dear friends at DIY Style. They gave another discount that you guys wanted from before. She gave another one recently, and everyone said they were waiting for a bigger one. So she's giving you free shipping and a few other things. And if you go to the newsletter that I sent out, it's in the newsletter, and I sent a link in both sides. So that was DIY Style. There's a specific link and a password, not a password, but a coupon code that you have to use in order to get your free shipping and everything. All right. I think that's it. Here are all the dates, though. You'll see this whole list. And if you need the newsletter, just send me a message. Terry said, how much would you say is in the bicep? My client is 32 inches wide. So, Terry, just real quick, let's look at this pattern. All right, so I'm going to bring this back down. if you look at this pattern here, measure, and I'm going to take your comment down, measure from here. This is how you measure the exact measurement on a pattern, from here to here. And I know that's a little bit higher under your arm, but that is the way that you measure the bicep. And whatever that measurement is, from there to there, take off the seam allowances, and that's the bicep. So if you find out that maybe you need a bigger or a smaller sleeve, you can do that. You can cut one size up or down without too many alterations. Connie Crawford taught me that years ago. She said, why reinvent the wheel? If you already have a sleeve, you just need an extra half an inch or something like that. Go to the next size up on the sleeve and just make a few adjustments to make room for it. I've tried that very successfully for quite a few years. So Connie, thank you for that great tip. Many years ago, she gave me that one. So yeah, very cool. Barbara, great to see you. And yes, we love you too. That's how much ease is in the bicep. So this measurement I just showed you, Terry, with the sleeve, that is the sleeve pattern, and that includes ease. So I have probably 2 inches of ease in this sleeve. I'm just guessing. It might be 2.5 inches of ease, because this fabric doesn't stretch. Now, somebody made a super cute version of this out of knit. So before I let you guys go, and don't worry, I'll be checking back your comments. Try to keep them in the groups, because it's hard for me to filter them all over Facebook. But let's see. Let me just bring this up for you, because you have to see this if you haven't seen it. I just have to make a few comments about it. I think I missed lunch today. I did miss lunch. I went to get my hair done today. Getting it ready for It's So Easy. All right, so let me bring my pattern down and you can see this. So here's Elaine's top to give you some inspo. Inspiration, right? Glenda, pizza, champagne, beer. That is the week. Isn't that true? Oh my gosh. All right, so... That's so funny. You guys didn't get that. That was last week. I didn't have my glasses on, and my nephew gave me all the requirements, my four-year-old nephew, of what is important. And I didn't have my glasses on and thought it said pizza, champagne, and beer. And it was pizza, campground, and beach. Something like that. Okay, so just Elaine, I love this. You guys are using different fabrics, and she actually added cuffs. So once you get rolling on this, you guys are going to have so much fun with this. It's a very simple pattern. I say it's beginner to advanced because of the collar. I know some people get stuck on that. Let's see. There's some fabric. Let me just find some. Judy, you guys are still posting photos. Well, guess what's coming next week? The giveaways. So this is the thing. You guys take a photo of how you watch behind the scenes. It could be today, could be now. I've been saving all of your names into a bucket, and I have more coming. And Brother is sending, I thought they'd be here by today, but they won't be here till next week. There are these really nice Brother things for your water, like for your drinks, to keep them cold. Super cool. It's a gift for you guys. So we're going to be doing random drawings of who wins these Brother awesome cup. They're not really cups. What do you call them? When you, not... You know the joke. How do you know to keep it warm or cold? A thermos. It's kind of a thermos, but it's super cool. So when they come, that's what we're giving away. So don't forget to share your photos. And you can share them on Facebook, Instagram. Just make sure you tag me so I can make sure that you're included in this. Okay, Trudy. This fabric, I love this. You guys were asking for new fabric ideas. This fabric reminds me so much of a piqué cotton. I just love it. I don't know if you said what it was in here. Fabric. Oh, she doesn't know what the fabric is either, but it's so cute. It just looks so soft, and you did such a good job cutting out the pattern. I mean, it matches up perfect. Everybody was commenting on that. Super, super cute. Here's Jan's top. Love this fabric. Look at that collar. That looks just beautiful. So those of you that are asking, you want a shorter collar? You can either attach the collar lower, just cut this away, or make the collar shorter. Now, Melody actually left the collar off altogether. Charlene, I love that top. I love it. I love it. I love it. I think I have that fabric and I'm going to make that. I just love it. Charlene's the one that gave us the cute laugh that she made it, that she didn't realize the slits were going to be high on the side. We got another one. She's quilting while she, don't mess up while you're watching me. That would be bad. All the way from Denmark. All right, so my overseas friends, by the way, I know you're going to be like, wait a minute. Don't worry. I have special gifts for you, too. They're just downloadable. If I draw your name and you're overseas, I got you covered. Esther, this is a version of the shirt. She pattern hacked it and made it into a total button-down shirt. Super cute. So I'm just going to scroll through these because we're going to be talking about these later, but I had to show off Amy's. She turned hers into a dress, which is adorable. Great fabric. Very, very cute. I knew she would pull that one off because she always makes the cutest dresses. Here's another one. Great color. Great fabric, too. That almost looks like a crinkled rayon. All right, Denise. Oh, here we go. Glenda made this for her husband. It looks amazing. Wynn came in and he's like, I want one of those. I said, call Glenda. Call Glenda. I have two sisters to make one for and a couple of friends that are on my list. There you go. There's Diane. Diana's. I love that fabric too. So I'm hoping you're getting a lot of inspo here. Pam has a whole thing on here. She used Karina's design and took it to the Luminaire and then from the Luminaire to the Scan and Cut and did reverse cutting. I think that's what you did here. Yeah, how to cut fabric on your Scan and Cut. Very cool. All right, where is, I'm scrolling through these faster. You guys are so bad. I laughed right out loud. Someone said, fabric grain line explained. Cross grain, straight grain, and bias. So all my fishing friends, if you're still watching this, I totally apologize. I didn't put this on here, but you know what? I was reading the comments and I think everybody said they understand grain line now. So here we go. Wynn thought that one was pretty funny too. He said you shouldn't put photos of him up in the group. I'm just kidding. So we have a few funnies in there. And then let me just see, where are you, Denise? There's Clovis. Check out what she did with this top. Two different versions. Lace. Did you use a knit in that, Clovis? I know I asked you. I can't remember. It sure looks like a knit, and I just love it. Great color on you, too. There's Debs. She said she was a newbie on this one, but you know what? She sure didn't look like a newbie after sewing that. And Roanne used the lace designs. If you missed this last week when I was showing this off, super adorable. We got Janet making another Evelyn dress. She's already moving on to other things. She's been sewing like crazy here. Janet did a two-tone. This is the Delilah. There's a two-tone for the Linda. Isn't that fun? All right. Charlene, I love that one. This is what's going on. Gail's embroidering lace. Here we go. Esther's in here watching the live show. I like your fan. Here you go. Denise, I was waiting for this one because I love this fabric. Here's another one. Another print. But it looks fantastic. So there's lots more to share. And we will be sharing, by the way, a big show and tell when we're finished. So you got the schedule. If you didn't get the newsletter, send me a note. Or actually, you don't need to send me a note. Go to AngelaWolf.com or Fashion Sewing with AngelaWolf.com and enter to get on the newsletter. I will be going through your notes and any fitting or technical fitting tips that you want me to put out, like this upper neck, if anybody needs help with a bigger sleeve, things like that. I will work on these when I get back from It's So Easy. That's a whole week away. So my mother obviously doesn't know we're live. So that way, but this won't be till after It's So Easy because I have It's So Easy next week. So check the schedule, join in the group. We have great people in there that not even if I'm not there, my sister helps. Everybody pitches in to help. Hope you guys have a wonderful day. I think I'm actually freezing. Not really freezing, but I'm freezing. So happy July 4th, everyone. Have a wonderful week. Check the schedule, and I will see you in the group. All right. Bye. Yes. Fran says, I need to get busy. That's the quote of the day. Everyone get sewing, unless you're going to the beach, of course. Bye, you guys. Have fun. Have a great 4th. And I can't wait to see what you're working on. And don't forget, if you have questions, you don't have to wait till the next time. Just pop in the group, leave a question. Bye, Esther. Bye, Glenda. See you on the 8th. Wynn will be waiting for his shirt from you. I'm just kidding. Bye, guys.